So me and my, well, I make music obviously, but me and my friends all have like started a collective, because a lot of us either make music or, you know, they're avid gig goers or they're into art in general. So we have a lot, we have a bunch of friends like that. So we all had like this common interest of just, you know, getting out, getting people's music out and putting gigs on, and just like other art too, ideally, you know, that's what we want to do. So basically we're just like a collective of people trying to get some art going in the area, mostly music, but other things too.
That's Spooker Rekkids, is that what you call it?
Yeah, Spooker Rekkids, yeah. That's the one.
That's the collective. It does help if we like... I like it. You make music obviously as well though, but like you are like a singer-songwriter. Haven't you been a singer-songwriter for how many years?
Do you probably about 10 now, you know.
10? I feel like I've known you like sort of maybe 7 or 8.
So yeah.
Thinking about it when I was at Mink.
It's, yeah, so I've done that a lot, like all myself, obviously. And then it was me and my friend actually come up with the name for the Spooker Rekkids thing. Because we just called, you know, Rekkids, and we put a record on and all that. That's what he was saying. So, and like John Horner, you'll know from Nell, yeah. And obviously he does loads of stuff. He writes for NARC and everything now. He's like proper involved. Him and a bunch of the others were just kind of like, we need to get a collective going. We want to do something so we can put all our music and all this stuff under one banner and get shows on and all this. So basically, I just said this name, Spooker Rekkids, and none of them were that bothered about it. And then I drew a little ghost on a bit of paper, and they're like, oh, he's canny, yeah, we'll call it Spooker Rekkids. But then, like, everyone sort of, like, took it from there. There's no sort of, like, driving force. Everyone, when they can, steps in and just does what they can. It works mint that way, because when people are busy falling off, other people pick up the slack, continue doing it, so it's really good for that.
It's class. How many of yous make up Spooker Rekkids then in total?
Oh, there's quite a lot. Like, there's a few of us dropping in and out, but I'd say there's probably about 10, maybe even like one or two more. Because like a few of them obviously drop in and out and kind of thing, like a bit more than others, but everyone contributes. And so yeah, there's loads of people involved, and like some of them are really good at organising stuff and getting stuff done, and others are, you know, John will be sort of like knocking up, getting in touch with everyone, getting all these bands together and doing compilations and things like that. And so it's like, it's proper good. Like, yeah, about 10 of us. So it's a lot more than what you'd generally get, I think, from like gig promoters and things like that.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Speaking from experience.
Yeah, of course.
So I guess, like, what inspired you to do Spooker Rekkids?
I think at first, because a bunch of our, like, me, myself, and our pals were all doing music. And like the others were all really, you know, going to gigs all the time. Obviously, you've got like Shiv and Rachel, and they've always been going to shows and, you know, and helping out and working the doors and things like that. So we just wanted to get like start putting some music out and then putting some shows on too. And obviously, from there, we ended up sorting the attic out, like cleaning this old attic out that hadn't been used since the 80s, and using that as our own sort of space. So basically, it was just to help us and our friends and just get some another set of gigs on, basically, like a bit different, something a bit more like, you know, intimate in a sense. Yeah.
The attic's upstairs in Westgarth, isn't it? Is it the third floor?
Yeah.
Third floor. I don't know. I was going to say, I don't know what the second floor is, but I know what the second floor is now, just thinking about it. Yeah.
That massive gigging room, yeah.
The gig room.
Yeah, but it was like an old... I think it was an old GP surgery, and it was the woman's bar at one point. That's why it's all that weird layout, how it is. It's got like a big window, and it's got a tiny little hatch you can open and look through. And it was just totally like unused entirely. And like Steve, obviously local legend, was happy for us to sort of clean it out and just use it how we wish. Like, we've recorded stuff up there, like videos. You'll have seen like loads of people have, like Tom Joshua's recorded videos up there, and Palace Watson has, and things like that. I've done photo shoots at least and things like that. And yeah, so it's been become like a nice space for people to go do stuff in as well. Like, obviously normally when we can, obviously at the minute.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we'll get on to that. So I'm just trying to picture these things, like it seems quite vague about what you all do, because it's such like a collective and so many of you all have different roles and that you're just sort of floating through. But like, is there any kind of like how did you learn all that? Did you just, are you all like just doing, because you know, have you all got like different skills?
Oh, definitely people have got different skills. Like people are better at other stuff, but like, it just seems to be really, really cohesive. Like no one's sort of like fighting, you know, to be in charge or anything. People are just like, oh, just, I've got this idea. Do you want to do this? And everyone will chip in when they can and do. So it's just mad. Like, funnily enough, that amount of people, you think they clash, but it doesn't really clash. People just get on with it. At first, like, I think people thought I was sort of like in charge of it, because obviously like I was pushing it for my records initially, and then everyone sort of jumped on board. Like, without, we all want to do this collective thing anyway, but I was doing that. So, and then so I've like stepped back loads, like in terms of what, you know, for like at times, like other people have. And it's just nice that everyone now is just like in there getting stuff done. Like someone will be off sorting out like this aspect, and someone will be off organizing this gig over here. And it's just really, really nice. It works, even though it shouldn't really.
I just had a great idea there, and it might be a sidetrack to the interview, but like I didn't know there were so many of yous, but oh, you all had your own little ghost.
You know, that's probably a good idea, but I reckon we should all draw our own individual one, you see, because otherwise that'd ask me to do it and I wouldn't.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm stepping back at the moment. I need to step back, these ghosts.
I like that idea though, that's good.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. I'm just thinking like,
the Brady Bunch logo, like everyone's little ghost there. I like that.
I just think, yeah, I can think of like the, because I know the ghost picture, and I know like the how that would look with different people in it already.
That is class. I'll pitch that to them.
Big question, and it's obviously the meatiest one. How has lockdown affected your work and your future plans as Spooker Rekkids?
So it did obviously had a big effect, because a lot of the stuff we were doing, like we were leaning well into the gigs, like getting people, you know, from all over, like really, really good artists from all over the country and stuff. And we had some stuff lined up. Like we had gigs literally just about to go on, like a week before, you know, we had cancelled gigs before we had to, in a sense, because people were coming from Scotland and their tours were getting closed. And we had like sort of Broken Chanter and all these Scottish bands coming down basically, and we had to just all collectively cancel it, sadly. So that affected us initially, and then we've been focusing a lot more on the recording side of things, I guess, like the past few months. Then obviously we had the idea to, not me per se, but the rest of them had a good idea to like help the Westgarth and start this fund, which has obviously been a massive focus of what we've been doing the past few like weeks and months, really, sort of behind the scenes, getting that sorted and getting in touch with other sort of the promoters and things like that, and bands. So that's been like a massive focus, in terms of like we have got no energy to focus on gigs. Most people have done recordings that they're doing and things. So yeah, this Westgarth fund's been like a big focus of how we've got to change and try and help the community a bit more. It's like the, you know, the music community, rather than just sit there and do nothing, basically.
It's nice. The campaign looks class. Like it's a, like it obviously worked like loads on it. I was reading through the crowdfunder the other day. Like I saw Heather Story's design and stuff, and I was like,
amazing. That I love that. Yeah. I absolutely love that. Like it's exactly. Such a good design. Like, and she approached us for that. She just popped in, slid in the Spooker Rekkids DMs and was just like, I'm doing these things, and like I've done one for the Westgarth, and we were like gonna do a print anyway. We had it up there of like something else, of the t-shirt logo basically, and that we were like, that's mint, like that needs to be a part of this. So we got that offer, and like she's just give us that basically, of just totally of, you know, of her own volition for free.
It's made me have a look at what I've actually donated and just like be like, oh, should I change it?
Well, it's like that. That's the thing. Like everyone stepped up. Like everyone locally has stepped up to help out these like get gigs back on at the Westgarth and like safely. And it's just mint to see. Like you see all the people who care about it, like genuinely now, just coming out and supporting. And obviously, we've all like. You know, we've all put these like things, these little things together, like John's doing the billiards tutorials and things like that. And we've got a few others we'll announce and stuff. Like we even have this is actually a bit of an exclusive for yourself here. We've got a song we're putting out. Like it's like almost like Band-Aid, like Bar-Aid.
Oh, is that the collaboration thing?
Yeah, yeah. That's the thing.
Cool.
So we've got like loads of people, like loads of local artists and just our pals and things. And we've put the song together. So yeah, that'll be going out like under
such a great singing voice as well. And I wasn't asked.
Oh no, it's been, got a bit awkward now, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's got really hot. Right, we have to end the interview, but it's not because of that.
Yeah, I'm sure it's not, yeah.
Thanks for your time, Rick.
No, thank you very much. It's good to speak to you.
Okay, man. Right.